release from a mental health institution. Geiser, you may recall, was sentenced to 40 years in the institution after she and another girl named Anissa Wire stabbed their friend multiple times in 2014. They were trying to praise a fictional online character. The state says Geiser is not psychologically fit for release. Her defense says she has made improvements. A standoff in Dane County is now over, turning deadly. Two people dead inside a home in the town of Albion. That standoff stemmed from an investigation in Dubuque, Iowa, where a woman and her 13-year-old daughter were found dead. Now, residents in Albion learned of a man who had barricaded himself in a home on Ramsey Road late Wednesday. This morning, we're told a man and a woman were found dead inside that home. A new White House rule aims to close a loophole that has allowed tens of thousands of guns to be sold in the U.S. every year by unlicensed dealers who don't do any kind of background checks on potential buyers. Chris Brown is the president of the Brady Group.
We believe that somewhere between 20,000 and 80,000 sellers of firearms will have to get licensed and conduct background checks as a result of this rule. So it's truly transformative.
The ruling is expected to face legal action. Time now for News About Your Money and the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Let's make sure I get you an update on the numbers here correctly. Let's take a look here. Right now, the numbers don't seem to be coming in, so I don't want to give you the wrong ones. We'll get you an update here coming up after the break. But right now, Annex Wealth Management, it's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com. Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time is 10:05. However, I do have the numbers, so I'll get them to you quick here. Fellows, thank you for that. The Dow is down 196. The NASDAQ is up 65. And the S&P at the moment is flat. Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, again, 10:05.
Carole King, one of the most beloved and successful songwriters of all time.
I feel the earth move under my feet.
The Fireside Theater presents Tony and Grammy Award-winning Beautiful, the Carole King musical. Her story from 18-year-old songwriter of Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow to writing hits for the biggest acts in music to the trailblazing success of her album Tapestry.
And it's too
Beautiful features such unforgettable classics as Pleasant Valley Sunday, We Gotta Get Out of This Place, You've Lost That Love and Feeling, On Broadway, The Locomotion, and of course, A Natural Woman.
You make me feel like a natural woman.
Every ticket to the Fireside includes memorable dining, spectacular gift shops, and free parking. Order your tickets now. Call 920-563-9505 or visit firesidetheater.com. Beautiful, the Carole King musical, through May 26th, only at the Fireside Theater.
WTMJ's Eric Bilstead here. Do you have achy joints, like a bad knee or maybe an elbow that barks at you, and you want to get help, but the idea of surgery or steroids makes you cringe? Well, there is another way. QC Kinetics. It's the future of medicine. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. We're talking natural biologics using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkup. Dr. Sheinkup's a pioneer in this field. 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, and he wants to get you relief with a needle, not a knife. QC Kinetics. They've got two locations, one in Greenfield, another in Mequon. Call today to find out how they can help you. QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. Get your free consultation from QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. Time now for a WTMJ Sports Update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. The Bucks have now won two in a row after their win, a big win, at Fiserv Forum over the Magic on Wednesday night. The Brewers looking to take another game from the Reds this afternoon. Not sure that's going to happen. The weather could be a little rough this afternoon. We'll let you know exactly if and when that game is canceled or postponed. Checking the roads, WDTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving, Time Saver Traffic. So far, so good right now. 94 eastbound is clear from Highway 16 through the zoo all the way into downtown. No issues. 4145 southbound, queue to the zoo is delay-free. And 43 southbound, looking good at the moment from Brown Deer Road into downtown.
Traffic is sponsored by the Heiser Automotive Group. For convenient car shopping and financing, visit Heiser Automotive Group at one of their four locations, Toyota, Chevy, Ford, Lincoln, and Cadillac, or visit Heiser.com, because today's your day.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Cloudy today, scattered showers, maybe even a rumble or two. You will hear the tornado sirens potentially this afternoon. Not to worry, tornado drill day today. High of 54. Tonight, some scattered showers, breezy, a low of 46. For your Friday, slight chance for rain early on. Otherwise, windy tomorrow, a high of 56. Saturday, sunny and mild, should be a nice one, high of 65. Sunday, slight chance for rain, otherwise gorgeous, sunny, mild, high of 74. Monday, partly cloudy, and again, mild and a high of 68. I'm Eric Bilstead, siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 10:09.
Live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in downtown Milwaukee, it's time to Fast Forward. Welcome to the future of almost everything in Wisconsin on the upswing. Joining WTMJ's Jeff Sherman, here's Steve Glenn and Martin Moore.
Welcome to the Upswing Thursday edition. Fast Forward, the future of almost everything in Wisconsin. Specifically for today's show, let's tee it right up and get going. Food delivery, daily habits, film, transit, 414 day, and more. We're going to go right into the topics with our always special guests and our friends, Steve Glenn and Martin
friends.
Moore.
Yes. Good morning.
Hey. Welcome, gentlemen.
We are friends, aren't we?
Yes.
I guess.
It is good. We're all friends in Milwaukee and Wisconsin. That's what community building is all about. Quickly, Steve Glenn, the Chief Milwaukee Officer at Experience Milwaukee and Text MKE, Marketing Director at MISO. Martin Moore, Content Creator, Podcaster, all things marketing, filmmaking at Koss Headphones. As we talk, if you want to chime in, the WTMJ talk and text line is 855-616-1620. First things, I need your take on a couple things here, gentlemen. McDonald's is doing billboards that smell like it's fries. And you want to talk about the future of advertising?
What?
This is it. So there's a Smells Like McDonald's film in the Netherlands that's being shared on YouTube right now. And people are noting they're walking past these billboards, no logos, just a single color. People couldn't look away, but they couldn't smell away either.
So billboards are, well, typically next to like freeways, right?
Well, some places they can like, be lower,
yeah,
lower to the people.
I feel like you don't need a billboard to smell McDonald's in many metropolitan areas.
Yeah.
It works, though. I mean, boy, when you smell those fries or you're driving past a Culver's and you them butter burgers.
I'm in the drive-thru.
Oh, yeah. Without a doubt.
Boy, they got the bait out there and they really... It makes sense. I just feel like they already do that without the billboards.
Yeah.
Now they can do
that's
it everywhere.
A good point.
Right.
Now they can do it in places that the company says they're strategically positioning them 200 meters within a McDonald's location so that... quote, any cravings the display may inspire could be easily satisfied.
I'm going to be curious how that goes with people who live near there, and now all of a sudden your yard every time you're outside, like playing ball with your kid, it smells like
cutting
McDonald's.
The lawn.
Well, I want to know the full technology behind it, too. How do you replicate that smell?
And does it give me cancer?
Yeah, I want to know the ingredients and what's going into it, right? Yes. So if Wisconsin companies are doing the same thing, what Wisconsin company should take this idea?
Really?
Smell root beer everywhere?
Like that honey and sassafras smell? That could be good. What else, Steve?
I'm kind of leaning this morning toward Gloriosos.
Ooh.
Those scents over there are really
like
delicious.
The Italian beef scent?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
It's a delicious sandwich. Yeah.
That will work.
I got to go.
Did you guys watch take in the community building that was the eclipse?
I did.
Yes. I watched people do it. I just stayed at my desk.
Okay. I really loved the aspect of it. It just kind of brought people together. It wasn't political. It wasn't sports. It wasn't a concert. It was just this thing that everyone had this sense of FOMO about, that everyone was doing, that you had to be a part of. And there's so few of those events in our world that it just kind of made me
smile. They're fun. It's nice. It's nice when people can just get together and focus on one ubiquitous thing that makes everybody smile and is interesting, and It was very cool. And then it was over.
All right. Well, I want to ask you about the future of those glasses that we were all wearing this week. We'll do that after the break. This is The Upswing, the Thursday edition with Martin Moore, Steve Glenn. It's the future of almost everything. You're listening to WTMJ.
Is your IRS tax debt making you feel anxious? The professionals at Allies Tax Relief are ready to negotiate your fresh start. Call them now at 800-230-5174.
Acunet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Vince Vitrano for Connect Chiropractic. Dr. Alex and his team have my neck, back, and shoulder feeling so much better. One of my fellow patients, Missy, said she actually went in with a slight limp a year ago. That's now gone. I met Tom in the lobby the other day. Said he came in to Connect Chiro after another doc wasn't helping him feel better. Now he's found his home for chiropractic care. You're invited. Open house Wednesday, April 24th, 6 to 8 p.m. at the office in Wauwatosa. Meet the doc, see the place, and learn how chiropractic care can help you. Go Connect Chiro. That's GoConnectChiro.com.
Rhinestone shades of cheap sunglasses. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah!
We all had the sunglasses earlier this week for the eclipse, but I want to know, what's the future of those eclipse sunglasses? Steve and Martin, are you hanging on to yours? Or are you doing the proper thing? Because there are three things that you should do with those glasses, and I wanted to make sure that we were tackling the future of the eclipse sunglasses in the proper manner.
Someone who lives and breathes in sunglasses 24/7. I'll just wear them around. I'll take selfies with them. I'll go to the library. Take them on the airport. I'll wear them.
What are you supposed to do with them?
You're supposed to either save them.
Yeah.
You know, as long as they're the right safety standards and compliance.
For 75 years.
Save them for the next one. Put them in a place that you know you're going to find them next time. So you don't have to wait in the long lines.
Future of heirlooms, right?
Yes. Or donate them. Astronomers Without Borders will take them. Many local schools will take them. Warby Parker locations. There's one in Madison. Mm. There's one in the historic Third Ward here. Yeah. Just bring them in. They will make sure they get in the right hands.
That's cool.
Or recycle. And if you're going to recycle, you take the cardboard eclipse glasses, you pop out the lenses, you dispose of those in the regular trash, and just drop the cardboard frames in wherever you put your recycling. There you go.
Simple.
One, two, three.
Very
that's,
simple.
That is the education around what we should
anything,
do.
Anything but like chuck them out the window of a moving car and let them sit on the street. Anything but that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think everyone should wear them on Milwaukee Day. Everywhere they go.
Ooh, that's a good tease for the last segment. 414 Day is coming up this weekend. We're going to give you all the details about that and more. So during the eclipse or not, did you have any food delivered? And when was the last time you had food delivered?
Yesterday?
What's your preferred platform, Steve Glenn?
I just went through the Jimmy John's platform.
Ooh, okay.
But it turned my $8 sandwich into $16. Don't tell my wife.
The price of convenience.
Wow. So Vox had a story recently about the future of food delivery, and I wanted to kind of bring it to the national, from the national level down to the local state level for us. But Vox says no one is happy about the delivery apps, not the customers who feel gouged by the avalanche of fees, like you just said, Steve.
Yeah.
Not the restaurants who feel gut punched by the commission that the apps are taking from them. Certainly not the delivery workers who have long been rewarded with a pittance for doing a job that, like, especially in big cities, has higher injury rates than construction workers. So who's going to win, and what's the future of these delivery apps? Because food delivery, it's not ending. It's convenient, very much so. But what's going to give?
It's a $38 billion industry, food delivery, and growing. And so I don't know. I get mad, but I'm super happy that I didn't have to do anything and it just shows up at my door. I have really mixed emotions on this topic.
Yeah. So locally, DoorDash will do a first order with the delivery fee waived with a $15 order. But after that, it's 15% service fee that starts with a $3 minimum. Hmm. So those fees, they add up. They add up quickly.
Yeah, and tips if you're going to tip in there.
Yeah.
Like I said, it doubled my sandwich order, and it was just a sandwich.
It really comes down, in my opinion, to two things. How much extra business do businesses want, and how much are people willing to pay for convenience? If either of those things are true or some sort of like net positive for people, they're going to stick around. If businesses weren't making money or were losing customers, they'd simply just...
That's a good point.
Opt out. And if customer, if it's too expensive for people, if $16 is too much for Jimmy John's, then you just won't buy it. So, I mean,
I think
businesses and people can complain all they want about the fees.
That's all that's happening right now is people are complaining, but they're still doing it.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. And so.
And the future is they're going to keep doing it.
Yeah, they'll keep doing it.
Right. And the reality is a lot of people need these apps because they can't get out of the house or they don't have efficient transportation. So like they rely on the apps to get their food.
Here's another interesting thing that I've always found about food delivery. In this kind of circles back to the gig economy that we've talked to a couple episodes ago. This is a whole new job and industry that didn't exist 10 years ago. Just like being an Uber driver or being a YouTuber or a gaming streamer or a food delivery driver. This creates jobs for people that maybe want a part-time job or want to hustle, or maybe they're retired and need something else to do, or maybe they don't have a high school or college degree and are struggling to get a job or whatever it is. It does create a job opportunity for people that didn't exist. And, you know, there's something nice about that.
And I know we're picking on food here, but when you think about delivery in general, have you had like a shopper at Target get your stuff and bring it over?
Oh, yeah.
We have.
I love that.
And that has higher fees, but as for some reason, people seem a little bit more tolerant.
Right, to do it.
Yeah. Any? Have you worked with any restaurants? Are they looking to kind of protect themselves? There is a Senate bill, Senate Bill 290, that goes into effect in July in Wisconsin that under it, the delivery services will not be allowed to list a restaurant's name or address without consent. I know on a local level, there's some that are like, wow, you're putting me in this app, and we really don't have the capacity to make sure that these deliveries go out efficiently.
And the menus are often inaccurate.
Correct.
Yep.
And then they're going to be required to share information with the restaurant about the content of the orders and the time they're placed. Delivery drivers are going to be required to have knowledge of the basic food safety principles, including personal hygiene and avoiding cross-contamination. So there's some things on the governmental level that at least we're trying to put in place to make sure that, you know, the apps are efficient and they continue to provide us what we want.
Well, exactly. The other thing, too, with food delivery service is a lot of times the taste of food is predicated on, you know, how long ago it was prepared. And if you have a food delivery driver that picks up something that was made 30 minutes, 45 minutes ago, it might not taste the way that the restaurant intended. They could get bad reviews. There's a lot of consequences for some of the things that are out of the control of these business owners and these restaurants when the food leaves their front door and then it goes into the car of someone who could sneeze on it or take it to the wrong place or deliver the wrong thing, and that's going to come back
tacos.
On the going to come back on the business. Yeah, eat one of your tacos.
Right.
Sip your Fanta.
Hey, why is the straw in there?
Well, we all have our daily habits, and we need our food, and we need it now. It's an on-demand economy. That's what we're talking about today on The Upswing, the future of almost everything. We'll be right back after this break.
Now there's a simple, easy, and effective way to clean your nose and protect your health. It's called Navage. Navage, available at Navage.com.
You can search for the biggest bat selection, but I'm here to save you time. Because the best baseball and softball bat selection in the Midwest is right here at Burkhart Sporting Goods. We stock just about every bat on the market from all the top manufacturers like Easton, DeMarini, Louisville Slugger, Marucci, and more. And sell them all at the guaranteed lowest prices. So get in here and try a few out in our indoor batting cages. There's no need to look any further, because when it comes to bats, if you want it, we got it. At Burkhart Sporting Goods.
You can't beat Burkhart.
When you run a team, you want great uniforms. And you know selling spirit wear is vital. That's why Burkhart Sporting Goods will create a free custom website for you to sell your families and players the coolest spirit wear from Nike and Under Armour, as well as the basics, while helping you fundraise at the same time. We take the hassle out of coordinating your team's apparel and make shopping and buying easy. So when you need awesome spirit wear and uniforms for your organization, you can't beat Burkhart.
You can't beat Burkhart.
Do you check your savings account and wonder if you're even saving at all? At Town Bank, we view banking differently and actually want to see your savings grow. With our amazing new CD rates, you can now earn even more, so you can sit back and relax. Stop banking the same way, expecting different results, and start earning more. Go to townbank.us/locknewrates or visit a Town Bank branch nearest you today. Bank differently with Town Bank. Member FDIC.
This is Senior Real Estate Specialist Bruce Nemovitz of Bruce's Team. We're honored to help seniors and their families traverse the journey of selling their longtime homes and moving to the lifestyle they deserve. With over 35 years of experience, Bruce's Team is here to help take you from overwhelmed to I can do this. Get started today and call 262-242-6177 or visit brucesteam.com.
Ready to tackle that honey-do list? WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Inspired Closets. Spring cleaning time. My friends Katie and Dan at Inspired Closets want to help you calm the chaos. Inspired Closets will transform your closets or laundry room, your pantry, any space in your house. They come out for a free visit and use their 3D software to tailor a space specific to you. Right now, get 10% off or 18 months free financing. Contact them today for more details. Tell them Vinny sent you. InspiredClosetsMilwaukee.com.
Every day she takes a morning bath, she wets her hair, wraps a towel around her as she's heading for the bedroom chair. It's just another day, slipping into stockings.
Another day with our daily Thursday ritual with Steve Glenn and Martin Moore. This is the future of almost everything on the upswing. I am fascinated by people who position and promote their daily habits, and I have a morning ritual that I stand by that I wanted to discuss with both of you, but I want to know, what is your morning routine? You get up in the morning, you must do what, and what does that day-to-day look like for you, Martin Moore?
Wake up at 5:30, hit the snooze till about 5:45, then I get up at the gym by 6. Then out of the gym, like around 6:40, we have a gym in our basement.
Okay, all right.
Then 6:45, shower, 7 o'clock, I make 2 over medium eggs with fruit and sausage and water. I start doing emails, catch up on the news. Then by about 7:30, I play Starfield for about a half an hour, and then I work at 8. And it's like that every day.
Every day.
Back when I was vlogging, I used to, because time was such a commodity, for about 7 years or 8 years, I wore the exact same outfit every day from Kohl's, the exact same Nikes, gray jeans, black V-neck shirt every day, because it was one less thing that I had to do. I didn't have to go in my closet.
Very Steve Jobs.
Yeah, figure out what to wear. I was able to shave off like 10, 15 minutes of my morning routine, which I allocated to, you know, vlogging and stuff like that. Yeah. So I have a very strict morning routine.
All right. And you incorporate that throughout the day then?
Like, oh, yeah.
Are you like,
your
schedule?
Yeah, my day is very locked in because it makes you efficient. You know, when you're, if you have a busy life, like that time is something that you can't buy. It's a very precious commodity. And so wherever you can find those minutes is very, very valuable for staying sane.
Yeah. Steve?
I wish I had a more structured routine like that. I have to, I do have a routine, which is I have to find some thinking time in the morning. And what the spot can be different, and depending on whether that's inside the house or outside the house, but there is one podcast episode I listen to almost every day, and I use that as part of my thinking time every morning.
Love it.
What is that podcast?
It's Gary Vaynerchuk.
I like it. Okay. Gary V, there's some good inspiration there.
As Martin was just talking about hustle stuff, he has an episode on abundance.
Okay.
And it just gets you thinking in the right mode. It gets me thinking in the right mode that day.
Yeah. Well, I need that consistency when I get up. It's about a couple different books that I read from that are just like inspirational verses and just to kind of get my mind right. Mm-hmm. I do my best to do a little thanks and gratitude. I have a notebook next to my desk or next to the bed that I write down things. I make the bed always.
Do you?
Always. Same. Yeah. Like me, I can't leave the house. I can't leave the house without my bed being
what?
Made. Like it is a thing. Even if I'm
wrong.
Yeah.
We make the bed at hotel rooms. Like when we stay in a hotel room, we make the bed.
Oh, really? So do I. Yep. Yes. Yeah.
I put the sign on the door so they don't make my bed ever while I'm at a hotel.
And then it's lemon water. So I juice a lemon. Heat it up a little bit, give half to my wife, half to myself, and it kind of gets the digestion going in the right way. Then the morning exercise routine is some squats, some kind of calf lifts, wall sits, and some barbell work, and then my push-ups. I do 40 to 50 push-ups every morning.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Yeah, so that's a little bit of my daily flex right there, but I've been doing it for 20 plus years, and I need it. Yeah. Right? It just makes sure that my head is right, my body's right, and then you can, into the gay.
What do you guys do then if there's an interruption?
I hate it. Like, there's nothing worse than, like, I wake up. I try to not pick up my phone when I wake up in the morning because it will just distract me from going to the gym or whatever it is that I have to do. Uh-huh. But what I can't stand is if I accidentally do pick it up or I get a notification and then I'm working out and I get distracted.
Yeah.
Because I have such bad OCD, it's all I think about. And like, I just completely shut down.
Well, when you talk future of communication, when you check your emails or your texts first thing in the morning, and I don't sleep with the phone. There's no phone in my room.
Nice. Really?
I have an iPad that I read in, but I'm not getting up and checking my messages right away. I do when I get downstairs.
Yes.
But I don't do that.
That's the first thing I do.
But I know many do.
That's the first thing I do.
Yeah. Does that stress you out?
No. I'm more stressed wondering where did I miss overnight?
Okay.
And there's just such
messages or news or to-dos, all the above?
All messages, emails, direct, other platform messaging, everything is just, it's a flood.
Okay.
And so I feel good. I check it off the list, get my coffee, go sit down and think.
Okay. All right. Mm. So the show prep, we're going to move that earlier in the day then and not late night. So we're not texting each other all night long.
Well, you know,
like,
I don't prep.
Come on. Here's all the topics. Like, here's all the stories I have to read by tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't want that happening. All right. Fine. I love it. Daily rituals. We all need them. We all need consistency in our lives. And we all need a little bit more gratitude and thanks in our life, too. So add that to yours. Coming up next, Siding Unlimited. WTMJ News Time is 10:30. ABC News and local headlines are coming up next. And then we're diving into the future of movies in anticipation of the Milwaukee Film Festival. This is The Upswing.
This is a special report from ABC News. O.J. Simpson dead. I'm Sherry Preston. He was a decorated college football star, then an NFL star, then a murder suspect and a convicted robber. O.J. Simpson has died. ABC's Rena Roy has more.
With athletic ability and star quality, he became one of the first black athletes to win off the field in the lucrative endorsement game. He starred in commercials on TV and in movies.
Yeah, from Dakota.
Creating a celebrity lifestyle. But that changed in June 1994, when Simpson's ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, was found brutally murdered. She'd been stabbed repeatedly and her throat was slit. Her friend, Ronald Goldman, was also repeatedly stabbed to death. Simpson quickly became a suspect. He was arrested.
Simpson's murder trial captivated the country. He was acquitted, but later found liable for the murders. He was also convicted of stealing his own sports memorabilia. He served time. He was 76 years old. This is ABC News.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 10:31. Decision Wisconsin, breaking news. State Supreme Court Justice Ann Walsh Bradley will not run for re-election. The justice says it's time to pass the torch. After 3 10-year terms, her term will end in 2025. More testimony today in Waukesha County, where Morgan Geiser is trying again to secure early release from a mental health institution. She was sentenced to 40 years after she and Anissa Wyeth stabbed their friend nearly to death in 2014 because of Slenderman, an online fictional character. Standoff in Dane County is over. Deadly. Two people dead inside a house in the town of Albion. That barricaded standoff began late Wednesday. It stems from an investigation in Dubuque, Iowa, where a woman and her 13-year-old child were found dead. The 16th annual Milwaukee Film Festival kicks off today, and weather may prevent that Brewers game. Brewers and Reds We're looking to wrap up their series this afternoon in Cincinnati. The weather could prevent that from happening. Time now for news about your money and the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. Right now, the Dow is down 202 to 38,259. The NASDAQ is up 58 to 16,228. The S&P is down 5 to 51.55. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite Financial Planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic. Looking good on the road at the moment. That's good news. For, let's see here, 94 eastbound Highway 16 all the way into the Marquette right now is a 17-minute ride, so that's delay-free. 4145 South Highway Q to the Zoo, no problems there. 43 southbound Brown Deer Road into downtown is also smooth ride. And 94 northbound from Layton into the Marquette, no problem getting in there. That's a 7-minute trip. The WDTMJ 5-day forecast for today. Some scattered showers are possible, maybe some clouds as well if there aren't rain drops coming down. A couple of things to remember, we do have tornado drills taking place today, so you will hear some tornado drill sirens going off this afternoon. If you do, that's not severe weather today, it's just the drill. The high today is 54. Tonight, scattered showers, breezy, a low of 46. Friday, there's a slight chance for rain early on tomorrow, otherwise windy, a high of 56. Saturday, sunny, mild, high of 65. Sunday, sunny, mild, high of 74. Monday, partly cloudy, mild, a high of 68. I'm Eric Bilstead, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 1034.
I like to be active, and as you get older, I know it because I am older. You're more prone to injury, and I could not get rid of the pain.
QC Kinetics patient Diane Richardson talking about how a hiking injury left her in awful pain.
No one wants to live in pain. I certainly don't want to live in pain. I don't have time for pain.
Diane had heard about regenerative medicine, so she called QC Kinetics and started treatment right away, and the results were incredible.
I couldn't believe it. I honestly was skeptical, but the pain went from a 10 to a 0.
QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in using natural biologics, healing properties from your own body to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. There's no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime.
The result was phenomenal. I mean, I was not feeling any pain. I'm able to do everything that I want to do.
If you have pain from arthritis or injury, this may be the solution you're looking for. Call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
It was a game changer.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
At Fisher Investments, we may seem like other money managers, but we're different.
Are you really that different than the rest of us?
We are. As a fiduciary, we always focus on what's best for our clients.
What services do you offer besides investing?
We have a team of specialists in financial planning, estate planning, and more.
Your clients rely on you for all that?
Yes, we ensure clients receive unparalleled service at every step of the relationship.
Okay, but you still sell commission-based products, right?
No, because we believe that's a conflict of interest. We prioritize service over sales goals.
So, then how do your fees work?
We have a simple and transparent fee that's a percentage of our clients' portfolios. So we do better when our clients do better.
Wow, we're more different than I thought.
At Fisher Investments, we're clearly different. Learn more at fisherinvestments.com.
Investing in securities involves the risk of loss.
Welcome back to The Upswing, the future of almost everything Thursdays. It is Steve Glenn, and he is Martin Moore. I'm Jeff Sherman. The Milwaukee Film Festival begins today. I had Ann Reed on, the interim CEO. It was on the Monday edition of the show. She really played up the importance of the walkability of this year's film festival. The Downer Theater reopens on historic Downer Avenue now. It's been closed for months. It's really easy to walk between the Oriental Theater and the Downer Theater. It creates a really good sense of community for this film festival. And it's frankly, it's different than the big mega screens, right? Nothing against the big mega screens, but the film festivals kind of bring it Indeed. Down to the community yeah. level, right? Yeah. And really make it easier to highlight the art of storytelling. And one thing Anne said that's kind of stuck with me, that film festivals are about kids and bringing your kids to a theater experience that, you know, maybe is a little old school, but that is worthy of moving into the future.
The future.
The future of films and filmmaking. What are your general thoughts, Steve Glenn?
I am probably the worst movie watcher of all time.
Okay.
But my family is heavily into movies, and we always have a movie on in the house. Everyone but me is regularly going to a theater. In fact, my wife and daughter and mother-in-law just went to see Gone with the Wind in a theater. And so I don't know. The film festival, I think, is an amazing thing for Milwaukee. I know a lot of the filmmakers who participate. It's a wonderful outlet for that creativity. I don't invest in movie time. I know this guy does.
Oh, yeah. I'm huge on movies and film. I love things like the Milwaukee Film Fest because every single large director or producer, whether it's Steven Spielberg or Bryce Dallas Howard or anybody, they all started somewhere, you know? And so those sorts of communities and events are vital for young filmmakers to learn what they did well when telling a story, what they didn't do well, and how they want to develop their career. Because here's the thing with movies is whether they're a documentary or it's something made up, there's so much technology that has stemmed from movies, whether it was Star Wars or Star Trek. There's so many phrases we use and words that we use that come from pop culture in films in general.
Absolutely.
And so they're a very important part of just, the human beings just interacting throughout the world. And movies are a lot like sports or the solar eclipse, where you can take the politics out of all of it and people can come together and enjoy one thing, like their favorite sports team or a film, and kind of rally around that. And it really brings people together in some really large communities. There's some franchises like Marvel and Star Wars and I don't know, whatever else is out there that are just massive and have massive followings, and it's saved people from depression. Films have, it has for me, and so I think they're a very vital part of then, now, and the future.
Yeah, I like the aspect of 100% entertainment. If I'm going to watch a movie, I want it to kind of take my mind to another space and just to be entrenched with it. Whether it's a Marvel movie or, and I want to talk about this after the break, a documentary, because I think documentaries are something I like to plug into because I feel like I'm going to learn something, but also be entertained.
Sure. Yes.
All right. We'll talk about documentaries and continue our discussion about the future of film. Steve Glenn, Martin Moore. This is The Upswing. We'll be right back after this break.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news. Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
A Brewers Group outing is the best way to celebrate any special occasion. Birthday parties, anniversaries, or bachelor parties. You can count on the Brewers to host. Brewers account reps make your day at the ballpark a breeze. Plus, get set up with customizable tailgate spaces, seating blocks in your favorite spot at American Family Field, and much more. Start planning your group outing now at brewers.com/groups.
Another MVP has joined the roster at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
Dr. Michael Nolte.
ExpertScape recently named him part of the top 1% of spine expertise in the world. Dr. Nolte has published over 50 peer-reviewed articles in leading scientific journals and authored more than 100 national presentations. They added this MVP specialist for orthopedic, neurosurgical, and spine care because at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, there is a difference.
Eager to remodel your kitchen, bath, or rec room? This is Rob Adair, and we're ready with a personal redesign for you. Adair Floors and Remodeling in Franklin. Give us a call and get personal care from Adair. 761-3660. AdairFloors.com.
Right now, the prices of diamonds are probably the lowest we'll see in our lifetime.
Diamond prices are low, low, low. Here's why.
It was hard to meet new people during COVID.
When a person meets their soulmate, they usually get engaged about 39 months later.
People started dating again only about 36 months ago.
Most of the people who got engaged during COVID
or immediately after COVID
were already in a relationship before the COVID lockdown began.
The Wall Street Journal even published a story about all of this.
Low sales of engagement rings created a worldwide oversupply of diamonds.
But now, engagement ring sales are beginning to pick up again.
By the end of next spring, this temporary oversupply will be gone.
And diamond prices will start climbing like crazy.
If you ever wanted to own a big diamond, this is the year to do it.
Find the Kesslers nearest you at KesslersDiamonds.com.
If you want to own a big diamond, the time is now.
Welcome back to The Upswing, the future of almost everything. Steve Glenn, Martin Moore, I am Jeff Sherman. Continuing our discussion on the future of film with the Milwaukee Film Festival beginning this week. Actually, today is the big opening ceremony and the first film. So a little tease, tomorrow my guest will be Beth Ridley. And Beth is a career consultant, and her brother, John Ridley, a big filmmaker born out of Mequon, has the current docudrama, Shirley, on Netflix. What are your connections with documentaries? Is that something that you need in your life to help you continue to learn?
100%. One of my goals is to, by the end of my life, is make a documentary.
Ooh.
Yeah.
What's
really?
The topic?
Yeah. The sex lives of the elderly. So, like, people in nursing homes, or maybe they had someone pass away. Because here's the thing.
It's more wild than you think.
We look at look at the elderly and our grandparents, and that's one of those things that you don't think about. But that's a massive, massive human experience and emotion, love and sex and all that. Mm-hmm. And it's one of those things that you don't want to think about, but they're active in the community, and it's a very fascinating story. And so I've always kind of wanted to tell that story about what is that like and really humanize a group of our population that sometimes doesn't get the respect that they deserve.
Yeah. That was the last thing I thought you would say, just to be clear.
Yeah.
Absolute last.
Hopefully no one steals my idea.
So that's right.
As much as I'm not in on movies, I'm all in on documentaries. Love them. I think there's just a trick in my mind that thinks it's all real, even though sometimes it can be more dramatized than others, and I'm in.
Are you okay with documentaries that are co-produced by the subject matter? So, like, Taylor Swift is an easy example.
Sure.
She's the executive producer for many of her outlets, right? Yeah. I mean, hey, here's my film. It's about her life. It's finally curated in her voice.
Totally.
Is that okay with you?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, same with, like, I believe that Paris Hilton one on YouTube that was really, really, really good. I mean, I take all that stuff with a grain of salt, and obviously we all look at ourselves through our own lens. But you can basically get the gist of a story, and if there's anything you're like, oh, that doesn't seem right, you can Google it. Google's
exactly
a thing.
Right.
I mean, one of my favorite all-time documentaries is Neat, and it's all about bourbon, and it's clearly being, like, it's got to be at least encouraged by all the distilleries that care about people consuming more bourbon. But it was so done so well, and how it educated you and inspired you want to have.
I need to watch that.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Well, and I think you look at the future of sports leagues, content creation is such a powerful component.
Yes,
and creating documentaries, whether it's the teams or the leagues or partnering, like the NFL does with HBO on Hard Knocks, all it does is further humanize the players,
make
non-fans bigger fans, and ultimately probably gets me to a game.
Yes. Oh,
absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean,
and that's what it's all about.
There's one thing sports fanatics can't get enough of. It's content from their favorite team. There's no amount of video about the Packers or the Bucks that, like, I won't just sit down and, like, watch. I'll consume everything that's thrown at me.
Right.
I'm that way for companies.
Okay.
Like some of the most like storied companies. I want all the inside.
Sure.
How did it happen? Where it was built? All that.
All right. We're going to have to find the right Wisconsin-based company to do our next documentary project together on.
Martin's got an idea.
All right. Yeah. Let's go. Let's do it. So Sunday at the Milwaukee Film Festival, you can get the full schedules online, but there is a documentary called The Hurricanes, and it tells the all-too-unknown story of the Houston Hurricanes, a team in the first women's full-tackle football league that was founded in the 1970s. And I knew nothing about this. So, like, looking through the sports section of the film festival, I was totally intrigued. I'm like, all right, this is something that's fascinating.
Absolutely.
I didn't know that there was a women's 1970s-based tackle football league.
I think there's a tackle football league here in Milwaukee. Or a team.
Okay.
Yeah, women's.
I love all those really small stories. This is why I like documentaries or even like films that are loosely based off of something like that. Is these little stories that you otherwise would never hear about. Like that one, what was that one about? I believe it was the six women who helped with like the moon, going to the moon and all that.
Yes.
I can't remember
that
what the
movie?
Name of it. Yeah, I can't remember what the movie
Hidden
was called.
Figures.
Hidden Figures. Yes.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's just little stories that you didn't care about or didn't know about or even know that, or Killers of the Flower Moon. There's another good one. If you've got 4 hours to invest, just really interesting, fascinating stories that actually mean something in our day-to-day lives that you would never think about wanting to know about. That's why I like documentaries.
Or you wonder why the story has never been told.
Right, right.
Yes, indeed. Well, there are riches in those niches, and there are stories that we need to be told because it's going to educate and enlighten us in some way, shape, or form. And that's what the Milwaukee Film Festival does. When we come back, we'll wrap up our conversation with Steve Glenn and Martin Moore. We're going to discuss the opening of the L Line and 414 Day, which is Sunday. I know Steve and Martin have big insights as to what's happening, the future of 414 Day. Coming up next, this is The Upswing. I'm Jeff Sherman.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar. Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on The Analysis Show. Presented by Potawatomi Casino Hotel and Curbless Ready to Drink Cocktails.
Fantastic.
Find The Analysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching The Analysis Show.
I'm WTMJ's Sandy Max. What makes senior living at Three Pillars so special? It's all about living life how you choose. Take it from my friend Bill at Three Pillars.
I've found all the sociability I need at Three Pillars. We have all kinds of activities. We have a supper club every month, movies, concerts, cards, and especially bridge, which I love to play. And so I am just as content as I can be. I really would recommend it to anybody.
Schedule a tour today at threepillars.org.
Here's to sweet summer days together with friends and family in Wisconsin. To discovering magic in every moment.
Come on, over here.
And to reconnecting through a world filled with wonder.
Wow.
Here's to supper club celebrations and dancing until the sun goes down. Here's to those who Wisconsin. Plan your summer getaway at travelwisconsin.com.
The Original Botanas Restaurant. Delectable entrees, 50 top shelf tequilas, 20 different margarita flavors. Stop by for lunch or before or after the big game. The Original Botanas on 5th Street.
Casa es su casa. That's Botanas.
Visit family-owned Ken Michaels Furniture and our in-store design centers where you'll still find beautiful, luxurious, heirloom-quality American-made furniture. Right now, save 30 to 35% store-wide and take advantage of our complimentary design services. Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today.
Sleep better and save more with mattresses from Milwaukee Mattress and Ken Michaels Furniture. Handcrafted in our Milwaukee factory, our mattresses utilize natural materials like cotton cushioning, which dissipates body heat, Joma wool quilts for warm wintry nights and cool summer evenings, and natural latex providing superior conformability and pressure relief for aching joints. Stop in today at any Ken Michaels Furniture store and save up to 50% compared to national brands.
Since 1955, Geist Garage Doors has been the trusted authority in Wisconsin. Hey, it's Greg Mancik. Don't let a busted garage door get you down. Give my friends at Geist a call. Doors and openers for every budget are available, and they'll even build custom designs to meet your exact needs. Check out geistdoors.com or call 262-784-4250. Or do what I did. Check out their amazing showroom in Brookfield featuring hundreds of doors, openers, and their custom design room. Wherever you are in southeast Wisconsin, don't think twice. Call Geist.
Don't think twice. Call Geist.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma Brand station.
Welcome back. This is The Upswing, and I am WTMJ's Jeff Sherman. I want to give away a gift card to the Mineshaft restaurant in either Hartford or Oshkosh. The Sherman family, we live in the North Shore of Milwaukee, but the Mineshaft in Hartford, it's an easy drive for us. I don't know, 35, 40 minutes. And it's a staple when we need to get away from the Xbox and the PlayStation and get into the huge game room like the $2 million game room at the Mineshaft. Great pizza too, and mom and dad are really good with hanging out. We can hang out at the bar, sit at the table while the kids check out the game room. Let's do caller number 855-616-1620 gets a gift card to the historic Mineshaft. And a friendly reminder that Thursdays, that's today, feature buy one, get one free pizza. So the future of city celebrations integrated today with the opening of the L line, the Milwaukee Streetcar, the Hop. Now you can get all the way from the intermodal station on St. Paul. If you're coming from Chicago, you take the Hiawatha, you jump off, you hop off at the intermodal station, and you can get on the streetcar and be at Milwaukee's lakefront. And that's a pretty cool thing.
That's cool. You can get around all the Milwaukee Day events that are happening.
Exactly. And you two are both pretty involved in the 414 Milwaukee Day event.
Yep.
You know, Milwaukee celebrates its city in a big way. You know,
huge way.
Bayfield has an apple festival. Warren's has a cranberry festival. But in Milwaukee, we celebrate an entire area code on 414 Day. And it's pretty, pretty cool.
On Milwaukee Day, everyone's from Milwaukee, and it's a great, there are so many celebrations, there are more celebrations happening this year, I think, than I've ever seen, including ours on Sunday at New Barons and Twisted Path, with music, food trucks, giveaways, including a TV, a special piece of art unveiled at the 414 Toast.
Ooh, nice. Local artist, I'm guessing.
Local artist.
All right.
But I say all that because every place I see is doing something like that, right? $4.14 deals, 4:14 p.m. There's going to be a special something, live local music. There's so much happening to celebrate on this Sunday. It's going to be 70 degrees.
Yeah, I just love it because it's a celebration of just the businesses, the culture, the art, the music, everything that embodies this city and makes it great. I love it. And there's not a lot of cities that do that really embrace their, not the area code, but just their city in general like that, the way that we do.
Or even their city's birthday.
Yeah, right.
You know, I talk to people from across the country, and they're like, what the heck is 414 Day? I'm like, what? You don't know? Sorry.
And in front of City Hall, I think at 10 a.m., the 414 banner, I think for the fifth straight year, the 414 flag is going to kind of come down City Hall. Bubbler bikes are free all day.
Ooh.
Milwaukee Downtown is going to be handing out free tote bags and notebooks. Fuel Cafe and Bel Air have complimentary breakfast burritos at this event, 10 a.m. at City Hall on Sunday. I think there's a boxing champion named Violet Lopez. She'll be at that event. Harmonic Harvest, you can see them on the side of one of the streetcars right now. They have a new program called Renaissance Threads that are inspired by personal stories from Milwaukeeans who are using recycled materials and fabrics in the fashion industry to create clothes. Mm-hmm. So, like, everyone is plugging in on this day.
Love it.
Koss has
headphones. We are going to be releasing, again, in a limited quantity, the Milwaukee Home Koss headphones. You can find those.
We're giving them away at our event.
Yeah, you are. Milwaukee's going to be giving some away as well.
Nice.
And so they're super cool. They're, like, the headphones and like the Milwaukee flag colorway, and it's pretty dope. So
on Milwaukee actually did a nice write up of all the things happening on Milwaukee Day if you need it. So go ahead there and check it out.
Fill your calendar up.
That's right.
bounce around the city, get on the hop, do some things, do all the things.
And a friendly reminder, it's not just Milwaukee. It is 414. We are greater Milwaukee. Sure, downtown Milwaukee is the heart of the state of Wisconsin, but 414 Day, it's for everyone across this great state of Wisconsin.
All the communities.
Mm-hmm. So let's plug in and let's celebrate. We'll do it again next Thursday with Steve Glenn and Martin Moore. This is The Upswing, the future of almost everything. We'll be back tomorrow. Coming up next, Wisconsin's Midday News with Greg Matzik and Jessica Tai.
Welcome to our Everyday Health feature brought to you by the Fraterton, the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network. We all know the importance of wellness and keeping healthy and understand the effect that it has on all aspects.